Italian sacred repertoire. This was a period of revolutionary change in music. Right at 1600, right at the turn of the century, music changed forever from that Renaissance four parts, rich polyphony, to what is recognizable really today, a melody, a chord playing instrument, and a bass line. This, what they called then, new style music, took hold eventually, but after some controversy, there was like a letter writing flame war between Monteverdi and Artusi about what the future of music was to hold. We are doing all new style music, that is to say, all 17th century music on our program tonight. Italy was the center of this major change in music, and we'll be doing sort of an Italian tour, not just in Rome, but also in Venice, on the eastern coast as well, and throughout Italy. We begin with Francesco Cavalli's Cantate Domino Exultate.
Thank you. Claudia Monteverdi, featured later on in our program tonight, was his course master and teacher. Cavalli was in fact the name of his patron. His own surname was Galetti Gruoli. He's best known for his operas. La Calisto, which premiered in Venice in 1651, is most frequently performed today. Cantate Dominos, alternating triple meter and recitativo sections, would have been heard in his operas as well. It is a short sacred song which borrows one sentence each from Jeremiah in the Book of Psalms and ends with a bright hallelujah.
Now a little about the next piece. Viadana is best known as the author of one of the first published new style collections of sacred music. His enduring nom de plume comes from the city in which he was born. His family name was Grossi. His name endures as a herald of the sacred Baroque, since he published in 1602, Cento concerti con il basso continuo, 100 concertos with through bits with basso continuo, the hallmark of that new Baroque style. This sacred song that you're about to hear is one of the examples of these works. One especially exciting feature is the sudden burst of fast notes that comes right along with the text, Veloci te exaudi me, speedily come to help.
Thank you.
arias, cantatas, and songs. Most of her works are for soprano solo. In the preface to one of her collections, she cites Francesco Cavalli as an influential teacher. The text for this sacred cantata is a contemporary Latin poem on seeking the presence of Christ in the Eucharist. It is from her Sacri Musicali Affetti, published in 1655.
Oh. Vespro della Beata Vergine, Vespers of the Blessed Virgin. The text is from the Song of Songs, but the composer, or possibly another collaborator, made modifications to the text to make it more clearly apply to Mary, to whom the entire piece is dedicated. The Vespers is a massive work alternating choral movements with motets for increasing numbers of solo voices. Nigra Sum is the first for a solo tenor.
Sent for those affinity of war.
embrace the new style language of operas, recitative, aria, and chorus, to tell a sacred story. In this case, the story of Jephthah from the biblical book of Judges. After commanding a major battle victory, he vows to sacrifice whoever or whatever comes out of his door first. Unfortunately, the terrible twist of the plot is that it's his daughter. So, in a climactic, dramatic, and musical moment, Jephthah's daughter, called only Philia, the Latin word for daughter, having accepted her fate, bewails the fact that she will die a virgin in this evocative aria. As she calls on the hills, mountains, rivers, and streams to wail with her, an echo repeats her music.
Thank you.
new style of music. Some of it experimental, some of it really, evocative, like what we just heard, and some of it just very simple and churchly as well. It really took hold and inspired the, Italy. Italy was the center of all this, and it really took hold and inspired the later Baroque, the German Baroque of the early 18th century. And then Italian opera up through the 19th century. All this had its sort of birth, origin, and nexus in Italy, the beginning and middle of the 17th century. Just exploring this music has been such a joy. I'm Michael Chevalier. I've taught here at Fairfield University for the better part of the last 10 years, and along with my colleagues, Katie Lindhart, Michael Kuhn, and Jason Werth, we're just so very grateful to have the opportunity to come together and perform for you tonight. We're grateful to the Fairfield University Art Museum, Linda Wolf-Simon, Carrie McWaver, and Michelle DiMarzo for here at the chapel. We're grateful for Father Mark Scalise and Duke McKinley for all the help you offered us as well. And mostly we're grateful to each and every one of you for coming to hear us and letting us share this music. We return to the Song of Songs for our final piece. We return to Finetti for our final piece. Tota pulcra es, O Maria. The text from the third and first antiphons from second Vespers for the Feast of the Immaculate Conception. And the text adapted from the Song of Songs, just like Monteverdi adapted it, Nigra Sum, to be more directly Marian. This is also an adaptation of that Song of Songs to apply more directly to Mary. This is Tota pulcra es, O Maria.